Let me just ask one more question, then I'll see if we have some in the audience. And this is a question I'm sure you've been asked many times by younger theologians. We have a number of students in the room and potential, perhaps, doctoral students someday. What would you say are some of the key and crucial theological questions that theologians should be wrestling with today? There's one or two things that if someone came to you and said, what really would be a contribution to theology or to the church that I should spend my time investing study in? What might you recommend to them?
I think I'd start by saying, what is the role of the theologian? And particularly in relation to the church, what has the theologian to contribute to the church? Certainly in the tradition I belong to now, and in my understanding of the tradition, Anglicanism, when I was an Anglican, it didn't seem to me that the theologian is somebody who determines what the church teaches. That's the job of the bishop. And I remember actually having a rather interesting discussion in Oxford, where we were revising the conditions, the terms of the awarding of the DD. And I objected to the formula that was being used, that was taken over from all the other senior doctorates, which said that Doctor of Divinity would give them to somebody who was an authority in the realm of theology. And I said, but most of us here are Anglicans, and according to Anglicanism, it is the bishops who rightly divide the word of the truth. It's not the theologian. And so if you ask, what's the job of the theologian? Well, I think Newman is clear. For Newman, the role of the theologian is someone who brings his learning to bear on the way the church teaches. He doesn't. He's not the source of this teaching, but he's concerned with its intelligibility. He's one of the ways in which the church's teaching is checked against tradition. I mean, also often, we talk about the tradition of the church, particularly the Orthodox, we talk about the tradition, and this is what we are expanding. But the tradition, and we say this tradition is the tradition of the fathers. But if you look at the last century, we have come through a period of enormous advance in our knowledge of the fathers. What you might have known at the end of the 19th century would be a comparatively narrow collection of patristic writers. And the way that they were studied reflected this, in the university, reflected this narrowness. Now we have a much broader understanding, but this is something that, in fact, scholars have given us. The whole resourceful movement in the Catholic Church, particularly, has had a dramatic effect on the availability of patristic writings to theologians. And this has been an enormous blessing for the church. But it's not so much a question of the theologians. What the theologians have done is make accessible to the church now the riches of the theological tradition. And that seems to be one thing that they can do. Another thing they can do, I think, is as it were, ask whether the church is really in touch with the tradition of the church. I mean, all too often we think we know why we teach something, but when we look at the arguments for it, the ground for it, it's much more intangible, much more slippery than we think. And a lot of teaching can continue in a kind of traditionalism that is not actually traditional at all. You must remember the remark that Yaroslav Pelikan, in the end of his days, an Orthodox theologian, said that traditionalism
is the dead faith of the living, tradition of the living faith
of the dead. Exactly. Tradition is the dead faith of the past, and tradition is the living faith of the past, and that involves That involves discernment, and it also seems that the voice of the theologian can function in as part of what Newman called the prophetic voice of the church. That it functions as a critique of the of what the church goes on saying, which is often, well, two things could happen to it. One is actually it can be just simply irrelevant. It is using terminology that no longer means anything to anybody much, and that the theologian ought to have the courage to make this clear. The other thing is that the tradition of the church is very much more much richer than the traditional teaching of the church often says. And it seems to me that it's the role of the theologian to make accessible